So to find the perimeter of this thing, let's break it up into kind of three distinct parts. One part for the perimeter would be these two sides of a triangle. Another part would be these two lengths of a rectangle. And then the last part would be half of the circumference of a circle. So the two little red pieces, the two parts of the triangle, plus the two lengths of a rectangle, one length, the other length, and then add to that half of a circle, half of the circumference of a circle. Now the reason we're finding circumference is because we're asked for the perimeter of this shape. So, for the two sides of the triangle, since we've got 6 here, and these congruence marks tell us that both of those are 6, we have two lengths that are 6 units apiece. And we'll add to that the two lengths, the blue lengths, that were both 19. I kind of wrote over it, but there are two lengths that are 19 units long. And then we have to add half of the circumference of a circle. Now remember, circumference of a circle. Circumference of a circle is 2 times pi times r. 2 times pi times the radius. Now the radius of this half circle would be this length, which corresponds with this length. In other words, it would be half of 6, which is 3 units. So circumference of the whole circle would be 2 pi times 3. In other words, it's 6 pi. However, we don't want a full circle. We just want half of a circle. And so we want half of 6 pi. And so 2 times 6, of course, is 12. 2 times 19 is 38, and half of 6 pi, of course, is just 3 pi, and so a final answer, an exact answer, we would take 12 and 38, add those together, which would be 50, plus 3 pi, and that would be our final answer in terms of exact numbers. And if instead we were asked for an approximation, you can take 50 plus 3 pi, plug it into your calculator, and that gives you about 59.425 units. So that's the perimeter. And just to recap, we took the two little pieces of the triangle plus the two lengths of the rectangle plus half the circumference of the circle. So that's the perimeter. The next problem deals with the area of the same shape. Now to find the area, we're going to do something kind of similar, but we're going to be a little bit devious about how we figure out removing this little triangle. So let's game plan this out. So we could think of the end cap as the area of a semicircle, which refers to this piece. And then we could add in one of the rectangles, in other words, this large, let's color it blue, add in one of these blue rectangles. So add a rectangle. But then we'll have to cut out the area of one of these triangles. So what that looks like, we'll subtract one of the green triangles. So the area of half of a circle, well, I know the area of one full circle is pi times r squared, and in the previous slide we saw that the radius of this circle is 3, so the area of the full circle would be pi times times 3 squared, or 9 pi. However, we want half of a circle, and so we want half of 9 pi. And we'll add to that the area of one full rectangle, and that rectangle, its dimensions are 19 for a length by 6 for a width. So 19 times 6. And then we want to subtract the area of one square. Pardon me, subtract the area of a triangle. Now I know that this triangle is an equilateral triangle, and so its area we could find using 1/4 times side squared times root 3. In other words, 1/4 times a side length was 6, 6 squared, square root 3. And 6 squared is 36, so we have 36/4 root 3. And 36/4 can simplify one step further to 9. So we have 9 square root 3. So that's the area of our rectangle. So we have minus 9 square root 3. And now we can do some simplification to get an exact answer. Half of 9 pi would be, well, we could call it 9 halves pi, plus 19 times 6 is 114, minus 9 root 3. And that, my friends, would be an exact answer, as strange as it looks. But we have a pi, a constant number, and a square root 3. And then you plug that whole business into the calculator to get an approximate answer of 143.726 square units.